Hi there, and welcome to Mock Question Monday. Today's question covers 4th edition task list item D01 or 5th edition task list item B4. And today's question is, Cinderella's urgency to get home before midnight is an example of, and your options are, free operant escape, surrogate MO, free operant avoidance, or discriminated avoidance. And the answer is free operant avoidance. So let's break down all our options. The first is free operant escape. Guess what? No such thing, which is good, so I don't have to talk about it. The next is surrogate MO. So this is when a once neutral stimulus acquires its MO status, something that you want or need, by having been paired with an unconditioned motivating operation. And that neutral stimulus becomes a CMO, conditioned motivating operation, and acquires that same value altering and behavior altering effect as that UMO. More simply put, when there's an association that makes something desirable to you just because of that association, like when you purchase something that's been advertised by someone you admire, the admirable qualities are being paired with that specific item. And so therefore, that item becomes the thing that you want because of its pairing with that celebrity person that you admire or idolize. Like when I bought Smart Water because Jennifer Aniston advertised it. Now, the CMOS also should also be known that it alters the value of consequences that are under the control of that MO with which it has been paired. Free operant avoidance, that's the correct answer. This is a type of negative reinforcement in which the contingency for responding is the prevention of the onset of an aversive stimulus. And there is no signal, there is no SD that is signaling that this aversive is coming. So therefore, responding can occur at any time during an interval prior to that scheduled onset of that aversive stimulus. And so therefore there's that delay of the presentation. Like if Cinderella rushes home before midnight at any time, but before midnight, she will avoid her carriage turning back into a pumpkin and her dress turning into rags. And well, you get it. You know the story. And now this is in direct contrast to discriminated avoidance. This is a type of negative reinforcement in which the contingency for responding is the prevention of the onset of an aversive stimulus, but in the presence of that signal or SD. So if the clock strikes 12 and she rushes home in hopes of avoiding everything falling apart, that would be discriminated avoidance. Some other examples would be when a traffic report signals that there's a lot of traffic on a particular highway, so you avoid that highway. Versus, back to free operant avoidance one more time, I typically avoid Los Angeles highways and freeways between the hours of 4 and 7. If I am going somewhere, I try to go anytime before that window of time because I'm trying to avoid traffic. There has been no signal. It's just free operant avoidance, something I do as long as it happens before the occurrence of the aversive, which is rush hour traffic. I hope that helps, and I'll see you all next time.